Hey, how are you, everybody? My name's Felt. We're back in Final Fantasy 14, and today my video is actually scripted. This is post-production Felt coming at you, not live. In the background is Castrum footage. It's an entire clear that I did on my summoner. I decided to use summoner footage in place of the dancer one because I felt that this kind of promoted my ideas of how this has been getting easier with time. Doing a summoner run wasn't very difficult for me. Like, I'd like to believe that I'm a pretty decent summoner player. Don't get me wrong, like, I'd like to believe that I'm good, but I'm, you know, probably above average at best. Now, don't worry, I know this is a 30-minute video, and you're looking at the time, you're like, how is he gonna talk for 30 minutes about Castrum? And I'm not. I'm gonna stop, and you're just gonna let the rest of the footage play out, you can watch the rest of it. At the final part of the fight, during the final boss fight, I'm actually part of the group that goes up top, so if you want to see that, you can skip to the end of the video and go watch that part of the fight. This video in particular is mostly going to be about how I feel Castrum feels after about a week. And this is going to be a much more detailed version than any of my other videos. So let's get straight into it. Castrum. It's a lot easier right now. It is a lot easier right now. You can get a lot more people in there. Most people are actually of the proper resistance ranks. Most people have gained general know-how from either watching other people's videos, hopefully like mine here, or just people have more lost skills. People have a much easier time using their lost skills to buff up. I'm pretty sure I'm using Spell Forge and Spell String in this video, both of which buff up the general damage of my party by quite a bit, depending on the boss fight that we're going up against. And the fights felt easier, but that could just be people knowing the fights better, or it could be me generally feeling like I know the fights better, but I'm not positive one way or the other. Strats, they haven't changed. They're pretty much the same. People have partially gotten more efficient with how to get all prisoners freed throughout this, but that's not really strats change, more like groups are getting better about being like, okay, we need these groups all to go northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast, and then everybody groups up on east and west, and then bam, we free all the prisoners as fast as possible. It's still not perfect. I'm pretty sure in this footage we miss a prisoner by like a second. Like, we get into the room, we're fighting the guy, and he kills him right before he dies. So obviously there's still issues and there's still learning curves, but overall it feels like it's generally gotten a little better. Going in with less than a full 48 man totally feels fine now. This is the second one in a row I've gotten in that wasn't full, and the last one I got into, the footage that looked weird and I decided to just ditch the dancer clear, it was only half full. I'm pretty sure it was exactly halfway full the entire time. It's just a little more difficult. The bosses seemed to scale a little bit health-wise, so it's not like, oh no, we have half the party, so the boss is going to take twice as long to die. They'll take a little longer to die, but not as long as you would think. Honestly, one of the hardest parts is probably the first fight. Both groups have to generally DPS the same amount, because if either group kills their boss first, the group up top or the group down below, they'll basically start triggering something that ends in a wipe, because it just becomes, just, you can't do it. There's either too many adds down low, or I don't actually know what happens up top. I don't think I've ever been in an up top group when we killed it first. On average, it seems like the group up top seems to kill a little slower, but I think up top is a little more mechanically complex than the down low, which is why, on average, people will spend less people up there. Most people typically will just be talking in yell chat about the boss's health, like whenever the boss hits 50%, one person from each group will typically try and be saying it out. And then when they hit 25%, and they hit 10%, they'll typically do the same. On average, that's how people keep track of where the boss's health are. It's mostly just like on people within each group to yell out in yell chat about the boss's health percentage. And that makes it so that either the top group or the bottom group kind of chill out on DPS, make things go a little smoother so that everyone can try and kill the boss at the exact same time to make the fight just generally easier. Now, the final fight still has a few issues. People seem to be dying to the boss's cross jump, and I say that by me. I die to the boss's cross jump. I don't find it super easy to read because it has to be based on where the boss is jumping combined with the marker is, and it can be a little difficult to read. I will firmly admit that I find it a little difficult to read, but once you get used to it, it's not as bad. I think by the end of the fight, I generally got good at reading it. This is only my third clear. Going up top for the final fight is honestly super easy once you learn all the boss's tells. If you want to learn the fight, just watch footage of it. It's pretty straightforward. The hardest part is probably his stone casts, because he does one with outward spiraling rings of stone and then crisscrossing lines of stone popping up across the platform that'll give you vulnerable stacks. I'm pretty sure I got caught in one of those this run, unfortunately for myself, but I didn't die to it, so obviously, I'm a gamer. Now, the last thing I'm going to talk about here is Castrum rewarding enough? And I say not really. You can't get chest armor from a single clear, even on a perfect run, I am pretty sure, because you just do not get enough coins. Even if you save all the prisoners and get all the coins from it, I'm pretty sure you still lack 5 coins to buy the armor piece, which is just rough. I feel like you should be able to at least buy one of any armor piece you want from a clear. And the fact that buying the stuff for the augmented armor costs 500 for certain pieces, and I believe 1,000 for others, is ridiculous. When you barely get 20 coins a run, needing 500 is a little obscene. The armor looks pretty good. I like the way it looks on my caster and kind of on the healer, but it's not my style, so I might be a little biased on whether or not the armor looks good, straight up. But overall, I think Castrum's pretty great and it's a solid experience. I hope that the changes that they're making to matchmaking and how long people have to get into the instances that they have talked about on forums, I hope those get put in place and I hope they work really well and make everything run smoothly. So that'll be it from me talking. I hope you enjoy the rest of the footage. I hope you enjoy watching the video and I hope that you like it enough to comment, subscribe, leave a like on the video, go follow me on Twitch, go follow me on Twitter. Support the channel as whatever way you can. Thank you very much. Enjoy everything else.